Moon vehicle production plans have been unveiled by Toyota Motor and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. This vehicle will aid the Artemis Project, which is being led by the United States and aims to make the first manned lunar landing in 2025, 50 years after the famous Apollo 11 mission in 1969. Both Toyota and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries announced their plans to contribute to the Artemis Project at a joint briefing that was held in Tokyo. The Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency JAXA also took part in the collaboration. In their statements, the companies reaffirmed their dedication to creating solar-powered lunar rovers. With this novel strategy, astronauts will be able to travel to the moon sustainably. It is anticipated that lunar rovers will be launched in 2029. First off, what is a lunar rover and why is it so important? A specialized vehicle made to explore the moon's surface is called a lunar rover. These robotic rovers are frequently used in space exploration missions to carry out tasks on the lunar surface, gather data, and conduct scientific research. They are essential elements of lunar missions that allow researchers to study the geology, atmosphere, and other pertinent aspects of the moon. Lunar rovers are designed to withstand the hostile lunar environment, which includes extreme cold, rough terrain, and lack of atmosphere. They carry a variety of tools and equipment for scientific experiments and sample collection, and are fitted with wheels or tracks to move across the lunar surface. In Kent, Washington, at Boeing's Environmental Test Laboratories, the Lunar Roving Vehicle LRV, the first lunar rover, was created in 1969 for NASA. The first one, which was folded neatly into a small storage compartment attached to the side of the lunar module, was launched on July 26, 1971, along with the crew of the Apollo 15 mission. With the lunar rover's help, scientists can carry out specialized and focused scientific research on the lunar surface thanks to moon rovers. The information gathered by these missions can help us better understand other planetary bodies by revealing important details about the geology, composition, and history of the moon. Many valuable resources are also thought to be present on the moon, including water ice in permanently shadowed craters. These resources, which could be crucial for sustaining future human settlements and extended missions to other planets, can be discovered and analyzed by moon rovers. Toyota, which is renowned for its engineering prowess in the automotive industry, is eager to use this expertise in space exploration. The company has previously stated its desire to assist lunar missions by creating vehicles that can navigate the difficult terrain of the moon. Likewise, Mitsubishi Heavy Industries contributes to the project with its adept technical skills and expertise in the production of aerospace equipment. The company, which has contributed significantly to numerous space programs, sees this collaboration as a chance to increase its level of involvement in the space industry. The joint endeavors of Toyota and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries are very much in line with the Artemis Project's objective to build a long-term lunar base. The moon vehicles hope to lessen reliance on limited resources and offer a long-term solution for transportation needs by powering a crewed lunar rover with regenerative fuel cell technology. The technology of the Land Rover has come a long way as it has been continuously improving over more than 50 years since it was launched. But one thing that is still a prominent problem is its high power consumption. Lunar rovers are energy-intensive machines. To run their systems and carry out their duties on the moon's surface, they depend on a variety of power sources. The amount of energy used by a lunar rover is determined by a number of elements, such as the rover's size, weight, instrument and system complexity, mobility capabilities, and mission duration. Batteries and solar panels are typically the main energy sources for lunar rovers. The majority of lunar rovers have solar panels that, during the day, turn sunlight into electricity. The rover's operations are directly powered by the energy produced by the solar panels, which is also used to recharge the batteries for use during the lunar night. A lunar rover's energy use needs to be carefully controlled to ensure its longevity and mission success. by planning operations to take place when solar power is at its highest and using energy effectively during nighttime operations, engineers and mission controllers maximize the rover's power consumption. This process is extremely inconvenient and is a waste of a lot of time and resources. In order to conduct long-term and stable research on the surface of the Moon, we are aiming to source various items on-site over a long period, Ken Yamashita, the head of Toyota's Lunar Exploration Project, said. A fuel cell automobile uses an electric motor similar to an electric car, but it gets its energy from a fuel stack where electricity is made by splitting hydrogen with a catalyst. Toyota claimed that its technology would electrolyze water and solar energy during the day to produce hydrogen and oxygen, and use fuel cells at night to generate electricity. According to the statement, the spacecraft is anticipated to be able to transport 2 astronauts for 42 days per year and remain operational for 10 years. Yamashita stated, "Our idea is to continue with the lunar rover longer than those 10 years if there is a company or arrangement that can supply the water needed for that." He added that clean water would initially have to be sent into space with it. Toyota does not anticipate being able to mine the Moon's ice water or produce water suitable for fuel cells on its own. Instead, Yamashita said, Toyota will likely rely on other businesses or potential future developments. In order to get ready for upcoming space exploration missions, including a potential mission to Mars, NASA's Artemis Project envisions sending people back to the Moon. Its objectives include both the conduct of scientific research and the testing of systems and technologies required for deep space exploration. The Artemis Project benefits from having Toyota and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries as partners because they have a wealth of knowledge and cutting-edge technology to offer. Modern Moon vehicles that can handle the challenging requirements of lunar missions are anticipated to be the result of their combined efforts. The lunar vehicles that will be launched in 2029 using fuel cell energy will be a demonstration of how far space exploration has come since the famous Apollo 11 mission. The movement of astronauts and supplies on the lunar surface will be greatly aided by these vehicles. The work being done by Toyota, Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, and JAXA serves as a reminder of the growing interest and cooperation in space exploration among international organizations. Partnerships like these will offer the resources and capabilities required to advance human understanding of the cosmos as the possibility of additional extraterrestrial exploration increases. The creation and use of fuel cell moon vehicles mark a significant advancement in environmentally friendly space exploration. Astronauts can stay on the Moon for longer periods of time thanks to the use of renewable energy, which allows for greater scientific investigation and exploration. The future of space exploration looks even more promising as the Artemis Project and its cooperative efforts advance. The inclusion of fuel cell moon vehicles not only highlights Toyota and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries' commitment, but also illustrates the potential for sustainable technological advancements in space travel. Did this video pique your interest? What do you think of Toyota's plan to use hydrogen fuel cells? Is this reliable in comparison to solar? What do you think future space exploration would be like? Let us know your thoughts in the comment box below. If you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.